This is a secret I carry with me. You'll see it if you know where to look. It's in the flash of my eyes when someone's breath is in my face. The grimace when that man on the train insists on my attention. The shudder when a hand at my back feels like a knife through my ribs. This is a secret I carry. Sits just below my heart, between my lungs, like a fist that won't let go, and it squeezes and squeezes and squeezes until someone puts a hand on my back and I burst. This is the secret I carry with me, through crowds of people who would call a smile an invitation, and a drink an agreement, and an admission of weakness a cause for scorn. Those people wouldn't see me, they'd just see my assault. I sit on the train with the man who insists on my attention. So I laugh when I flinch at the hand on my back. So I shudder but say nothing to the reek of scotch and potato chips that invades my space. I say nothing because this is a secret I carry with me. Because I hear the conversations of the people on the train, the people in the workplace, the people outside the restaurant, and people talk. It always starts with shock. Not for me, of course. But the lines are always the same. How awful, how abhorrent, they tell me. Yeah, could he really have done it? And I nod along like they're saying the right words, and I wonder how she's doing. And I nod along like they're saying the right words. I wonder how she's doing. The disbelief. It never goes away. He's such a good guy, they tell me. I met him once. He was so nice. and I mutter an assent. As if 30 seconds can tell you everything about a person. But he's a good guy. He's a good guy. I know they said that, but he's a good guy. A good guy. Sure, maybe he did it, but he's a good guy. Stop interrupting me. I said he's a good guy. He's a good guy. Didn't you know? I've been told he's a good guy. What a guy. I've been told he's a very good guy. He's a good guy. He's a good. Rather believe in the smiles and the rainbows. It's fine. No. I mean, it's not fine, because the disbelief doesn't just go away. It scoots over to make room for the anger. And the people on the train, in the office, outside the restaurant, aren't angry at your attacker. See, people talk.
What was she wearing?
You saw it, right?
It was definitely her fault.
Why did she keep talking about it?
Why didn't she just go home?
Why was she alone?
They talk about how Christine waited decades to report and couldn't possibly remember. They talk about how Emily Doe couldn't be sure. She didn't say yes. They talk about how Andrea couldn't attract that kind of attention because she wasn't his type anyway. They say Kalia was too young to understand. Regardless of who he is on that particular day, they say if he'd really done it, someone would have said something, and it's always that way. No one said something. No one said something, or he would have been caught ages ago. No one said something, or his bosses would have found out. No one said something, or someone would have done something. No one said anything, or Weinstein wouldn't have prospered. No one said anything, or Cosby wouldn't have been cool. No one said anything, or Levine wouldn't have made it at the Met. No one said anything, or conservatories wouldn't hire predators. But the whispers were always there, and people talked! people talk. And one day, I told the people I trust that I am among the untold victims. So they started talking about me. They asked if I was misremembering. They asked if I said no. They asked why I'd waited decades to report. Why I hadn't done something sooner. They told me I wasn't his type. They told me he was good. They told me I should have done something, and they still tell me, but the voices are shouts, and they're drowning me in the sound, and the things I want to say the most are the things they shout down because he hurt me! And all I can hear is run, run, run. From them and from him. I know the first rule of assault is don't tell. But now I know why. Because I say I've spilled my guts, but with the hand at my back and the knife through my ribs, I think they did that for me. And I bolt up in my bed, gasping for breath and grasping at the truth. The fist still sits below my heart. The whispers still whisper in the street below me. But the secret I carry is still locked inside. You'd never be able to tell. And this time, I'm keeping it that way. Because people talk, you people talk, but not about how much this hurts.